Hey everyone, how's it going? I'm Dalen. I'm going to be playing some acoustic guitar for you today. I'd like to kick it off with a very new tune that is so new that it actually doesn't have a title. So if any of you think of a title and want to comment it, feel free to do so. But yeah, I hope you enjoy this unnamed original. Thanks a lot. Hope you enjoyed. The next song I'm gonna play for you is a new arrangement of mine. It's a John Mayer cover. Critics have actually described me as Canada's answer to John Mayer. True story. This is a cover of one of his more recent songs called New Light. This won't hurt a bit. Thank you. Hope everyone's enjoying themselves tonight. If you are, that's about to change. Thanks, everyone.
All right.
How about a tune that I don't believe I've played yet on one of these live streams? I'm running out of repertoire really quickly, but this is a tune by a singer-songwriter who I really, really like, named Theo Katzman. He's also a vocalist and guitar player and drummer, and probably other stuff with Wolfpack, but he's also got some great stuff under his own name, and this is a song off of his album Heartbreak Hits. It's called Love is a Beautiful Thing, and this is my fingerstyle arrangement of it. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Here's another kind of mellow tune that I haven't played in a while, so hopefully I remember it. But it's one of my early originals. It's called At a Later Time in Life. Hope you enjoy. And if you don't enjoy it, just send me a message and I will send you my lawyer's contact info. You can take me to court. I've been sued multiple times, so no harm done if you decide that legal action is necessary.
Thank you.
through that. Man, I think it's been about 7 trillion years since I played that song, so I had to improvise large sections of it, but yeah, hope you enjoyed. If anyone's a fan of the Beatles, then you should recognize and enjoy the next song I'm about to play. If you're not a fan of the Beatles, then you will not enjoy the next song I'm gonna play. In which case, comment the most hurtful thing you can think of. Everyone, how is Here Comes the Sun? It's a tune I played for my first ever girlfriend. The first thing I look for in any girl when I'm deciding whether or not I'm interested in her is intelligence, because if she doesn't have that, she's mine. Thank you. everyone's favorite genre of music, a real crowd pleaser at any social function or any party, any get-together, and that is jazz, of course. What else would I be talking about? This is the song that I played. I go to Humber College for jazz. Which, in combination with a $20 bill as bribery, got me in to the program. This is Take 5 by Dave Brubeck. Songs. Don't worry, you won't won't have to listen to me for much longer. Soon it'll all be over. Hope no one has PTSD from this performance. Usually at my gigs I give out a form to sign, and just in case anyone experiences any emotional distress or any medical problems as a result of my playing. It's been known to cause seizures and heart attacks and extreme weight loss even, which is weird. I've got a team of scientists trying to figure that one out. So if you are feeling unwell after tonight's performance, please do go to your nearest doctor. It's been known to happen after my shows. I'll close off with an original here. This is a longer song. This is one of the few songs I have that has a story behind it, which I won't tell, because it's extremely deep and meaningful and you wouldn't get it. So, but yeah, it's called She Sounds Like Summer, and it's another tune I haven't played in quite some time, so wish me luck. And thanks to OMCI, as always, for hosting this this live stream and giving me an opportunity to play my music for people other than my parents and people like my parents. Hard to get out and play much today with COVID. Not many gigs out there, so I'm grateful for this opportunity. Anyway, this is a tune called She Sounds Like Summer. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. I'm Dalen. Had worse. Anyway, thanks for tuning in, everyone. Hope you have a great rest of your night. Farewell. Cheers.
So hello everyone, I'm Jesse, if you can't already tell. I have, as per usual, a few covers, a few originals. This is one of my favorite songs to sing, just because it's so dramatic, and we know that is what I love. Anyways, this is Dancing With Your Ghost by Sasha Sloan, however you say your last name. Yelling at the skies, screaming at the world. Baby, why'd you go away? I'm still your girl. Holding on too tight, head up in the clouds. Heaven only knows where you are now.
Maybe you're just harder to see than
How do I trust again? I stay up all night, tell myself I'm alright. Maybe you're just harder to see than most. Dancing with Your Ghost. This next song is by formerly my favorite singer, he kind of still is, Ed Sheeran, who honestly, I owe like half of my love and appreciation of music towards him, because you know, I don't know if it's the same for any of you, but I feel like there's a point in life when you stop listening to, or you never do, but I feel like some people stop listening to music just to listen to music, and they start really falling in love with artists. And Ed Sheeran was the first person who I was like, wow, that is a talented individual. And I have to listen to everything he does now. And that's what I did. And in one of his interviews, he played this song from when he was like 12 that he wrote. And it was garbage. It was hot garbage. I will tell you that. And it was when I was like, this was still the phase when I was like, I'm going to be a doctor. That is the plan for me. Because honestly, music is just fun. I'm not like a pro at it. He's like, yeah, because I was 12, that's why it sucked. And then I kept working on it, and now it sounds great. Because now, and I was like, oh yeah, it's not gonna get better if I don't do anything. And then I started doing things, and I realized, no, this is definitely what I love. So now here I am. So yeah, that is my little rant of how much I love Ed Sheeran. And this is called Autumn Leaves.
Another day, another life, passes by just like mine. It's not complicated. Tear.
that's my favorite Ed Sheeran song. And yeah, I don't know. It just reminds me when I used to sing it. Oh yeah, once again, not being rude, just have to use my iPad as control for this piano for some reason. But yeah, that song just reminds me of like dancing around the kitchen like 2 summers ago, drinking green tea. So it's good. It's a good feel. Okay, so this next song, don't mind me and my lyrics, but it's kind of new. It's Taylor Swift's new song. It's called Cardigan, and it's my favorite, I would say. So that's Cardigan. Still figuring out the verse because for some reason I cannot remember that melody. So, anyways, next, what should I do next? Let's do my original. Look at me, by the way. I'm remembering to fix the piano before I go on to the next song. I usually forget. So this song, I've been playing for you sporadically as I add on to it because it's an original I'm working on. And for some reason, I am taking 1,000 years to finish it. So as I say every time, if I show you, it gives me motivation to finish it because, you know, then people have heard it. Like, it feels like it needs to come out. And I really like this song so far. So I added on like a little piece that kind of makes sense. So that's my story. I might as well show it to you. And I like singing it. Draws me in to pull away. If you'd ask him, it's just a game. Can't find a resolution.
the shadow he cast as he crossed the line. It was paved so neatly, shoes still squeaking. My eyes were down, cast down. I frown. I think it's the shadow he cast as he crossed the line. It was paved so neatly, shoes still squeaking. My eyes were down, cast down. I frown. He's a dead man. He's always in disrobes. Devil comes wearing different clothes. I drift again. In whispers, paint a different kind. Where I'm alive and life's just fine. I'll sing again. Close conversations from his head, remembering the words he said.
To be a little bit sad to tie into the rest of it, so then you can go. I think that sounds nice. And then somehow I can get back into the where I do that whole chorus. I love knowing English. So anyways, that was that. I don't have a name for it yet because it's not even done yet. So, you know, enjoy. Now, this next song is kind of old, I'll be real. And I used to love to cover it a while ago, but this lady, Billie Eilish, just released a new song yesterday. And then I went on like a spiral of listening to Billie Eilish. And then I saw she has this track on Logic, which is like just a music production software thing. So you can see how she found it or recorded it. And like, wow, that's a lot of harmonies. That's a lot of talent. And that was in a bedroom. And they didn't even plan on doing anything with that song. It was just for like a dance competition. So anyways, speaking of artists that inspire me, Ed Sheeran, Billie Eilish is also on the list. So this is Ocean Eyes.
I've been walking through.
No, that's not how it starts.
I've been watching you for some time. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. Burning cities and napalm skies. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes. Those ocean eyes. No flare. You really know to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. I've never felt quite this high, falling into your ocean eyes, those ocean eyes.
That song is higher than I remember it being. Also, thank you to all of you in the comments. All of you being two people, but it is the thought that counts. Now, yeah, let's do an original. If we're going to be singing songs that I sang a while ago, let's sing a song that I wrote a while ago. I haven't sung it on here for a while, so I think it is due. This is Hold On. And it's my song. Took me a while to notice you're not the same as you used to be. It doesn't bother me. Wish you were okay. So just hold on a little longer. If not for you, hold on for me. So just know you're not alone. I could be your home. And believe me when I say I can bear the weather. And I know it can't be. Have to, and because I had to sneeze that whole time, I just started finishing the song before I sang the last bridge and chorus, and I was like, I should do that, and then I lost my sneeze. Maybe it will come back. You know when it will come back? During this next song, because that is just how me and my sneezes work, so that's nice. anyways, we're on to guitar now, just for kicks. And this first song is by, yeah, let's keep it consistent, more people who inspire me. This is by The Lumineers, who is one of my favorite bands, 10 out of 10 for them. And this song, I mostly am obsessed with because I was obsessed with the music video. I thought it was so cool. And I ended up listening to it a bunch of times, and I was like, aha, I'm gonna sing that. And I'm remembering now that, oh yeah, never mind, I don't need the chords, I remembered it. Every time I say that, it does not go well, but we're gonna see how it goes today. Knock on wood, even though it's painting, haha. Anyways. I was Cleopatra. Switched a few verses around just for fun, just to see if you guys were paying attention. Now, Prochaine. This song is by another little lady from this program, Jessica Sporrell, and it's called Strangers. It's one of my favorite songs. So if you like it, you should check it out. Jessica Sporrell. Oh, also, I was gonna say that song I was singing, the one that was like, it's called Hold On, and ironically enough, today is July 31st, and Alyssa Bart's new song, Hold On, just came out. So you should listen to hers. It is just as cool as mine, maybe better. I really like it. So yes, anyways. Sorry, just got me on the topic of releases. Oh yeah, there's been lots of releases today, and then Absolutely You also released an EP today that you should check out. Cool day for the Ontario Musicians Co-operative Incorporated. That's nice. Okay. some things just don't settle like they should. The time moves on, and so did we. We hid our scars, and we showed our teeth. It might seem strange to lose a piece of yourself. Strangers by Jessica Sproul. 10 out of 10, would recommend. Now this next song, let's put the cable here. I'm sure probably all of you will know, all four of you, and it is called How to Save a Life, and it's a very good song, because I was going through all my old songs, and this is why we're going on a little trip today of all the songs I used to love to sing. And I still love to sing, hence I'm singing them today. And that way you guys get to hear some songs I haven't sang in a while. Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just a talk. He smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through some sort of window to your right. He goes left and you stay right. Between the lines of fear and blame, you begin to wonder why you came. Where did I go wrong? I lost a friend somewhere along in the bitterness, and I would have stayed up with you all night had I known how to save a life.
Bitterness.
I used to sing that one all the time at the elderly home when I sang there, and that was like one of the only ones they liked. I did sing old songs for them. Maybe they were annoyed that I was singing old songs. Maybe they wanted to hear new songs. I do not know. That's my story. Now, next, I have an original song for you. Yes, I do. It is called Perfect Socks. I wrote it just a while ago, and I think I'm quite the fan of it. Just a while ago, as in like a couple days ago. It's the way you stand so tall. It's like your genetics knew it first. You would always be ahead of me. It's the way you're not from Barry. In a place like this, you'll expect to be an underwhelming entity, but no, I don't blame myself. I've become what the world around me wants, a bitter girl with holes in her socks. I've got two holes in my socks. Socks are perfect. I bet they're white, but somehow never stained. They're keeping people entertained. And I see that you've got intellect. I know that you think you're smarter than me. It's a problem, because I will always believe you. You know I always believe you. That I have lived upon all these years. I've never just gone crazy in this place. Till you came around, it only took one day. You showed me all the things I could have been, all the things I should have been. Song, and I'm trying to decide which to do. I've decided. This song is really fun to sing. I sang it on piano last time for you, but today we're going to do guitar. And it is Hope is a Dangerous Thing for a Woman Like Me to Have. And I'm going to have a drink of water before I sing it, because it's kind of hard to sing. Do you like this giant water bottle I stole from my sister? I do, that's why I stole it from her. Anyways, here we go. I was reading some errands and I got to thinking that I thought maybe I'd get less stressed if I was tested less like all of these debutantes, smiling for miles in pink dresses and high heels on white yachts. But I'm not, baby, I'm not. No, I'm not, baby, I'm not. I've been tearing around in my bloody white gown 24/7, Sylvia Plath, writing in blood on the walls, cause the ink in my pen don't look good on my pad. Don't ask if I'm happy, you know that
the best I can say, I'm not sad. Cause hope is a dangerous thing for a woman like me to have. The triad. Hello's the most famous woman you know on the iPad. Calling from beyond the grave, I just want to say hi, Dad. I've been tearing up town in my bloody white gown like a goddamn new sociopath. Shaking my ass is the one thing that's last. Got this black narcissist off my back. She couldn't care less, but I've never cared more. So there's no more to say about that. Except hope is a dangerous thing for a woman like me to have. Dropping the keys on my nights off. I've been tearing up town in my bloody white gown, 24/7 Sylvia Plath. Writing in blood on the walls, cause the ink in my pen don't look good on my hat. They write that I'm happy, they know that I'm not. Well, at best I can say I'm not sad. Hope is a dangerous thing for a woman like me to have. Hope is a dangerous thing for a woman like me to have. Hope is a dangerous thing for a woman like me to have. But I have it. I have it.
That's that. That is my last song, and that is all you have for me. So stay tuned. There are lots of good musicians on the way, and thank you for watching.
Hi. I'm good. How are you? Yeah, sure. I'm good. Yeah, cool. Hey everybody, how's everybody's night doing? I just want to start off by thanking OMCI for this amazing opportunity. Yeah, it's been so amazing and fun studying with you guys for this program. So I hope everyone is doing well. I hope everyone is staying safe. And I hope everyone's having an amazing night. So yeah, I'm gonna sing a, I think you guys have got me for 45 minutes. My name is Rachel Binns, and I'm gonna do maybe 7 or 8 songs for you guys today. Yeah, so I think that'll be fun. So I'm gonna start it off with one of my favorite songs. This was actually the first song that I tried to learn how to do by myself. It did not work out that way at all. It's an Adele song, and I remember listening to it in my room and thinking, like, you know what, like, I feel like this is simple enough that I could learn this on my own. And I think I tried to figure it out for like 2 weeks, and then eventually I gave up and I sent it to my guitar teacher at the time, and I was like, can you figure this out for me, please? And then I think he sent it back to me within like an hour and said, yep, here you go. And I was thinking to myself, I'm like, wow, thanks for that ego boost. And it is actually a fairly simple song. Like, it's just this and like then up 2 frets. Like, it's the same shape. You don't move your fingers except up and down. So yeah, this is, I don't know, I think it's one of my favorite songs. So yeah, this is Daydreamer.
Daydreamer sitting on the sea, soaking up the sun. He is a real lover of making up the past and feeling up his girl like he's never felt a figure before. Jawdropper looks good when he walks, is the subject of their talk. He would be hard to chase, but good to catch, and he could change the world with his hands behind his back. Oh. Can find him sitting on your doorstep, waiting for a surprise, and he will feel like he's been there for hours, and you can tell that you'll be there for life. A daydreamer with eyes that make you melt. He lends his coat for shelter, plus he's there for you when he shouldn't be. But he stays all the same, waits for you, then sees you through. Feel like he's
has been there for hours, and I can tell that it'll be there for life, and I can tell that he'll be there for life. One of the first things, maybe not the first things, but one of the very beginning things that they teach you when you're learning how to sing is don't smile when you're singing. Because it just makes everything sound more nasally if your face is stressed out. And just with that song, I just cannot help myself. It's every single time. I'm like smiling through the whole thing. So that's that one. The next one that I'm gonna play for you guys, let's do that one. So the next one that I'm gonna play for you guys is actually something that I was taught only to accompany. I wasn't actually supposed to sing it at all. And after a while, I couldn't help myself anymore. And a lot of people know this song from Shrek, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. That's where I first heard it too. And Leonard Cohen actually wrote two alternative verses than like the mainstream ones. And so I'm gonna switch out one of the verses for you guys for one of the other ones because I like them and I like it. This is Hallelujah. Secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair, she broke your throne, she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew Hallelujah. 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 Baby, I've been here before. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew you. I've seen your flag on the marble arch, and love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I did my best, I didn't come to fool you. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of song with gone above, and all I ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who helped you. It's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah, so that's that one. I'm gonna get some water really quickly. Okay. Alrighty. So the next one that I'm gonna do, a little more low key. the first time I heard this song, I think it was on Facebook. I was just scrolling through my social media one day, and I think it was on Facebook. But I have never, I don't know if this is the original. I don't even know if this was like acoustic. But it was just this artist and then a bass guitar, because it's a pretty jazzy song. And normally when I think of jazz, I think of like brass instruments, like saxophone, trumpet, all that jazz. No pun intended. So it was just this singer and this bass guitar. And the way that he sang this song, like you could tell that he was really missing someone and that the lyrics were so important to him. And I was just so incredibly moved. So I learned how to play this song. And recently it has created this whole new meaning for me because I have a special someone. And he is also very far away. So I definitely think that I can empathize with what this musician was feeling. So this is Ain't No Sunshine. Ain't no sunshine. Sunshine when he's gone, and he's always gone too long. Anytime he goes away, this time wondering where he's gone, wondering if he's gone to stay. Sunshine when he's gone, and his house just ain't no home. Anytime he goes away, I know. Hey, I leave the young thing alone. But ain't no sunshine when he's gone. Ain't no sunshine when he's gone. Only darkness every day. Ain't no sunshine. sunshine when he's gone. And this house just ain't no home anytime he goes away. Yeah, so that's that one. I don't know what's wrong with my throat today, but it's feeling a little bit raspy. Alrighty. Okay. So a little fun fact about me. I have something called synesthesia. And so there are, okay, I could be wrong. So don't take me for my word. But I think that there are three types of synesthesia, and it's basically there are extra, I think it's synapses in your brain, so you connect certain things with other things. So I think you can have taste, colors, and I can't remember what the third one is. And so for my form of synesthesia is that I see colors and numbers to a degree. So like when someone plays me a song, like I can see the colors in front of me, like everything just kind of turns that hue of color. Like numbers have personalities to me. And so like when I hear somebody's name, like they go, hi, my name is Brianna. Like that's automatically a red to me. Like I'm like, oh, nice to meet you, Brianna. And then when I get to know them, they're assigned a number that matches their personality. So that's just how my brain works. And so this song is called Home, and this is one of the main songs where it's very prominent to me. Like whenever I play this, like it's very vividly yellow, because also like certain chords have colors to me because they sound different. So like a C is very yellow, A minors are like maroon, D's are like this very light shade of blue, like baby blue, and G's are green. That at least makes a little bit more sense, G and green. But yeah, so this just has like a C prominently for the whole song, so it's a very vividly yellow song for me. And I don't know, I really like the color yellow, so this is one of, I really like to play this one. So yes, so this is Home. Just want to make sure I have this on the correct fret. I'll cry if I'm wrong. No, this is good. Okay.
Your home. Ooh, 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 ooh,
song called Home, but this one is by Philip Phillips. I am almost convinced that there's another song called Home, because every time I type it up into YouTube, it comes up with something else. But yeah, that's Home by Philip Phillips. Love him. So the next one that I'm gonna do, also on the fifth fret, brilliant, is more of like a campfire-y song, at least in my opinion. My sister and I had like a select set of movies that we loved to watch growing up. And my dad always bought our movies on VHS. So we had like this huge collection of VHS movies when we were little. And this is one of the ones that we had. And it was it's called Road to El Dorado. I don't know how many people know that. I don't know if it's very mainstream or not. But yeah, she and I were obsessed, and we knew all of the words to all of the songs. And so I was just humming it in my head one day. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna learn how to play that song. And it's actually Elton John, which I love because Elton John is amazing. I think he does the entire movie. Just like I think Billy Joel does the entire movie of Oliver and Company. He at least does one song, but yeah, I think Elton John does this entire movie. So no wonder we loved it. I'll just grab the lyrics. There they are. Beautiful. Yeah. Okay. So here is, Without Question.
The more I love, the more I see, the less the world impassions me. The hungry heart, the roving eye, have come to rest, do not apply. The frantic chase, the crazy ride, the thrill is gone. I step aside and not believe in anything. Were not for you, oh, show me by just existing, only this is true. I love you, I love you, without question, I love you. The more I want, the more I steal, the more I hold, the less is real. All worldly things, I follow blind, in hope not faith was paid in kind. The line is drawn, the change is made, I come to you, I'm not afraid. I love you, without
showing me by just existing. Only this is true. I love you. Without question, I love you. Yeah, so that's like this little fun one that I like to play. Very campfire-y. So next one. What are we at? Oh, okay, 20 more minutes. The next song that I'm going to play is apparently very common amongst the emerging artists this year. I think I was informed that there is I think it's just called Song Bingo, but there is apparently a list of songs that a lot of us have been playing. And every time that you play one that's like been sung a lot, you check off like this box of like bingo. And I think this one is on the song Bingo, so I'm gonna play it because I think it's fun. So this is the first time I heard the song. Well, the first time I heard Dolly Parton ever was with one of my best friends, and I think she was showing me 9 to 5. I think that was it, which is a brilliant song and one of my favorite songs. I think she showed me 9 to 5, and then she showed me this one, which is also an amazing song. That was the first time I heard this, and I learned to play it a couple years ago. The fingerstyle intro took me a very long time to figure out. This is Jolene. Oh, hold on. I apologize. Okay, now we're good.
Jolene, Jolene.
Yeah, so I hope I punched off a hole for, not a hole, but a stamp for song bingo. What should we play next? I know what we'll play. So the next song that I'm going to play is another Adele song. I love Adele, if you didn't catch on. My mom's birthday was yesterday, so shout out to my mom. Happy belated birthday. I bring that up because I can't remember what birthday it would have been, but for one of her birthdays when I was younger, she got the 19 and 21 album on CD. And I swear, I listened to those CDs the whole summer, definitely more often than she did. Like, they were on repeat. And so fast forward a very long time, and I was listening to them again. I can't remember which one it was, but listening to one of them in my room on repeat, as one does with Adele. And I came across this one, and I was like, you know what, this is the perfect opportunity for me to redeem myself with my Adele song learning abilities. Pardon me. So yeah, this one, I was actually able to figure out by myself. Yay. So that made me feel a lot better. Yeah, so this is, you know what? We're just gonna play it. Ah, there it is. Okay, yeah. So this is Crazy for You.
Myself today singing the legend name. You said I'm crazy, and I am. I'm crazy for you. Sometimes sitting in the dark, wishing you were here, turns me crazy, and it's you who makes me lose my head. And any time I'm meant to be acting sensible, you drift into my head, turn me into a common fool. Tell me to run and I'll race, if you want me to stop or freeze, and if you want me gonna leave, just hold me closer, baby. Oh, baby, crazy for you. Wish you come over, send me spinning closer to you. My blood boils, my sweet taste for you strips me down bare, gets me into my favorite mood. I keep on trying, fighting these feelings away, but the more I do, the crazier I turn into. Chasing flaws and opening doors, hoping you'll walk through and save me, boy. Because I'm too crazy.
So there's that one. The next one that I'm going to do, this is actually going to be the first time that I'm performing this one. yeah, so this one is a song that I learned about a summer ago. I really, really like it. I think it's a really pretty song. Every single time I play it, I for the life cannot have the starting note. Like, that's the beginning note. And as soon as I start the intro, I will forget it. I just don't know. Can't help it. So yeah, if I do the intro and then go, it's to get my beginning note. So fingers crossed that doesn't happen. We'll lock it in right now. Okay, yeah, that should be good. Yeah, so this is the first time that I'm going to perform this. So fingers crossed. This is Honesty. Yep, done it. She said, baby, I'm afraid to fall in love. 'Cause what if it's not reciprocated? Told her, don't rush, girl, don't you rush. I guess it's all a game of patience. She said, what if I dive deep? Would you come in after me? Would you share your flaws with me? Let me know. Told her thinking is all wrong. Love will happen when it wants. Know it hurts sometimes, but don't let it go. 'Cause I want you. I want you. Stuff that we don't want, but I can unpack it for you, baby. She said, what if I dive deep? Would you come in after me? Would you share your flaws with me? Let me know. Told her thinking is all wrong. Love will happen when it wants. Know it hurts sometimes, but don't let it go. 'Cause I want you. I want you. Yeah, so that is that one. I think I have time for one more. Oh, I'm trying to decide between, you know what? I think that'll be the perfect length. I've got like one long song, one medium song, and one short song stuck in my head. I'm at 5 minutes and I'm wasting time talking about it. Okay, so yes, the next song that I'm gonna do, we're gonna speed run through the mumbo jumbo that I usually talk about before I sing the song. I know being a Canadian, I should know French and I should know English, but I don't. I only know English. And I recently moved to a bilingual province. I moved to New Brunswick, and there I met one of my best friends who is from Montreal, and she was perfectly bilingual. Like, I'm talking like she knows grammar in both languages backwards and forwards. So she helped me, coached me through this song for like a year. And now I think I've got it. So that's the crash course on the history of that song. So this song is called La Vie en Rose. Thanks everybody for tuning in. Thanks for having me. I hope everyone has a wonderful rest of their night. Good night, everybody.